the actions of the Trump presidency revealed the dishonorable fact of the president's betrayal of his oath of office, betrayal of our national security, and betrayal of the integrity of our elections.
Simply put, it's not what she wanted. The speaker has been working to steer her caucus clear of impeachment proceedings, but within the past 48 hours, dozens of House Democrats, many from moderate districts, have jumped on board.
I had been pushed and prodded here in Congress to support impeachment for a long time, and I didn't do it. I was judicious about it, and the most important thing to me is that we have to bring the American public along with us.
The president responding as he is wont to do with a series of tweets. Presidential harassment reads one, all caps, a total witch hunt, or a continuation of the greatest and most destructive witch hunt of all time. Illinois Congressman Brad Schneider has been calling for an impeachment inquiry to begin since August.
Here we have the president of the United States and his personal attorney publicly stating that they put pressure on the president of Ukraine to initiate a sham investigation of the president's, one of the president's political opponents.
The president must be held accountable. No one is above the law.
This follows the president's admission that he talked about Vice President Biden and his son in a phone call with the Ukrainian president, working to leverage an investigation that might benefit his odds of re-election. Mr. Trump's opponents now weighing in. Bernie Sanders on Twitter calling for the impeachment process to begin immediately.
It is time for this administration to stop stonewalling and provide the Congress with all the facts it needs, including a copy of the formal complaint made by the whistleblower.
This election is over. I realize 2016 did not turn out the way Speaker Pelosi wanted it to happen, but she cannot change the laws of this Congress.
Republicans with a very strong response late today, and at the United Nations earlier, the president reiterated that he did, in fact, call for Ukraine to reopen an investigation of Joe Biden, almost daring Democrats to impeach him, which they are, in his words. And those of a whistleblower, these proceedings are hanging on those words, a historic moment that Republicans are hoping will energize their base. In fact, the Trump 2020 campaign, Micah and Joe, is already fundraising off of this right now.
All right. Thanks, Tom.